Look at this. It's a GLI and it's VW number 2. That's pretty cool.
Well, here's Andrew's homemade U-Haul.
Okay, so it looks like it came on a lot easier than it is coming off, but I finally got it so it's rocking on here. I could just cheat and use the loader, but I'm scared I'll wreck something, so it's a delicate balance here before see if I can get this rocking. Let out the winch cable and forward and back and everything. There, see that log is it's coming back a little bit. Little bit at a time. Okay, a little bit more finagling, and now I've got it where I'm actually pushing the truck forward as I'm putting it down. It's blocked up over there fine, and I'm all the way at the front over here, so it's just a little bit more finagling. I got this Buick 350 right in the way. Almost there. So the guy was trying to tell me that he could rebuild his Dodge alternator for $20. He said he could rebuild his alternator for $25, or they would rebuild his alternator for $25. I don't know if there's any truth to that. I'm sure you guys, I know you can repair a Dodge starter, but I don't know about a Dodge alternator. But okay, so this railway tie has to go right under the front, and then I think we're just about done here. Okay, and there's the final placement, kind of. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna lift up the side a little bit and get it level again, use the level and get it perfect. And then what else I plan on doing is just straightening it out a little bit. So I'm gonna get the loader over here and get this one all perfect, and then it'll be good to go. Then I gotta get this Buick 350. This was not the original to this car, but it was a 73, I think, and my car is a 72. And so I'm just, it may or may not go with the motor. Depends on the buyer of the Skylark if they want to return it back to the stock way it was. And if anybody needs to power their subdivision, I got this guy. I don't know. Nobody seems to express any interest in the thing, but I might just scrap it. There's a lot of copper in that thing, and it's a non-PCB thing. The oil was tested and everything, so it's a good one. So there'll be no environmental problem. But this is a good core to be rebuilt, and then we can have this set aside, and maybe the right buyer might come along and buy this stuff. I know it's getting increasingly hard to find like exhaust manifolds and stuff of that sort, so good for parts.